Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video I will show you how to install Ubuntu 22.04 on MacBook Pro 2012. So MacBook Pro will dual boot macOS and Ubuntu. Ubuntu is an alternative OS to install on MacBook Pro which is no longer supported by Apple's latest macOS. Before I start this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. First, open your favorite browser. Then go to google.com. In the Google search box, type Ubuntu. In the Google search results page, click on the Ubuntu Enterprise Open Source and Linux link. Now we are on the main page of the Ubuntu website. To download the Ubuntu ISO, click on the download menu. Then click 22.04 LTS menu under Ubuntu desktop. The Ubuntu download process is in progress. And the download process may take some time depending on the speed of your internet connection. The Ubuntu ISO download process is complete. Now open a new tab again. Then go to google.com. And in the Google search box type Belina Etcher. On the Google search page click on the Belina Etcher link. To download Belina Etcher, click the Download for macOS menu. Belina Etcher download is in progress. Wait for Belina Etcher's download process to complete. Belina Etcher download is complete. Now click on the Show in Finder icon. Drag the Ubuntu ISO and Belina Etcher files to the desktop. Now plug the USB flash drive into the USB port of the MacBook. The plugged USB flash drive will be mounted on the desktop. Now open Disk Utility. In the Disk Utility window, click View and then click Show All Devices. In the left window of Disk Utility, click USB flash drive, and in the right window of Disk Utility, click the Erase button. On Scheme, select Master Boot Record. On Format, select MS-DOS FAT. And for the name of the USB flash drive, I choose Untitled. Then click Erase. After the erase process is complete, then click Done. Then close the Disk Utility window. Now mount Belina Etcher file by double clicking on the file. Then drag Belina Etcher to Applications. Then close the Belina Etcher window. Now run Belina Etcher via Launchpad. In the window that show up, click Open. In the Belina Etcher window, click on Flash from File. Now select the Ubuntu ISO we just downloaded. Then click Open. Now click Select Target. Then click USB flash drive which will be used to create USB Ubuntu. To start creating USB Ubuntu, click Flash. It will require administrator password, so I will enter it now. Then click OK. The flashing process to USB will take a few moments. Alright, now the flashing process is complete. Then close the Balina Etcher window. Now open a terminal window. On terminal type disk util list. And then hit enter. Now look at the Apple disk type APFS. I will resize this disk to 150 GB. Now in a terminal window type, sudo disk util apfs resize container disk 0s to 150 G. And then hit enter. Type in your Mac admin password and then hit enter. Wait for the disk resizing process to complete. The disk resizing process has been completed. Now in the terminal window type again, disk util list. And then hit enter. As you can see, the disk size has already changed to 150 GB. Now close the terminal window. Now restart the MacBook to boot into the Ubuntu USB. After the MacBook screen turns gray, press and hold the Option key until the boot options show up. On the boot menu, select EFI Boot USB Flash Drive, and then hit enter. On the Ubuntu bootloader, select Try or Install Ubuntu. And then hit enter. Give it a moment to load up the system. Now I need to lower the brightness on the screen so that the screen can be recorded clearly. As you can see, you'll get a screen with two options. Because I will install Ubuntu Dual Boot with macOS, so I choose Install Ubuntu. Now select your keyboard layout and then click Continue. On this screen we are asked to select the software we want to install Ubuntu. I'm using a normal installation, so I chose normal installation. Also, I choose to install third-party software for graphics and Wi-Fi hardware and additional media formats. Then click Continue. In this type of installation, since I will be dual booting macOS and Ubuntu, I chose something else. Then click Continue. Now in the partition window, I click on Free Space. This free space I created earlier using Terminal on macOS. Now click on the plus icon. In the Use As section, select Swap Area. In the Size column, I type 8096 MB or 8 GB. Swap is a space on a disk that is used when the amount of physical RAM memory is full. Now click OK. Now scroll down, then click on Free Space, which is under Swap Partition. Then click the plus icon again. On Use As, leave it as default. On Mount Point, select As Root Partition. Then click OK. As you can see, there are already two partitions for Ubuntu, namely Swap Partition and Root Partition. If you have everything set up, you are now ready to click the Install Now button. And then you will be warned once again the change. If you are sure with everything, then click Continue. Then select your time zone and click continue. In the user and password configuration section, fill in according to your configuration. Because I don't want to enter my password when logging in, so I click login automatically. Then click continue. The installation process has now begun. This can take anywhere between 10 minutes to an hour. Take your time, wait it out, and let Ubuntu do its thing. After the installation process is finished for Ubuntu, now click restart now. After click restart now, we'll get screen saying please remove installation media. Then hit enter. MacBook will start restarting and then boot back into Ubuntu system. Now I need to lower the brightness on the screen so that the screen can be recorded clearly. After you've logged in, you'll be welcomed by a little wizard for Ubuntu. In this window I choose no, don't send system info because I don't want to send information to Canonical. And then click next. I'm going to turn off location services, no need for the computer to know where I am. And then click next. In the ready to go window, just click done. Now we are ready to use Ubuntu Linux on MacBook Pro 2012. Next I will check all hardware if working normally on Ubuntu Linux. So that's it. If this video is useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, just comment down below. See you in the next video.